Hello, Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Fer'al, where we're actually playing on a broken build. The game recently updated, but there's a few problems with this one. Not too much of a problem there, you still play and everything. You just can't do these. You know, all these levels are broken. Not sure why, but no well. Kind of a pain in the ass though. We've got 7 days to go. I got 10 more levels to climb. Oh well, never mind. So anyway, how about we head off and do a couple of quests. First, to the swamp. I didn't get my dailies today. So I'm guessing I have to go to the camp. Which would be this place. Alrighty then. What's all over there? A bugger. Wrong place. Okay, I'm gonna quickly do this one. And then we'll get over there. Well, here we are. And you know, one of the first lessons they teach you in Keeper Corps training is, doesn't protect your pride, it protects the planet. I'll let someone else take the lead. Can you help me out? Out on a recovery mission, she finally trusted me to oversee a core assignment, but it's not going well. Haunted plants and agriculture. It's actually a pretty classic case, you know. The spell goes wrong, the swampy soil soaks up dark magic, and suddenly you've got a cursed daisy or an evil tomato. Some kind of monster, magical buildup in the marsh. Haunted plant case. Oh my. That's a lot. Pumpkin patch. Let's try the dangerous plants before. Alright. Alright then. Chop that one up. Here's another. Now let's chop this one up. Now there should be another. Oh, there we go. There's another. Now we've got two to go. Okay. I wonder where the rest of them are. Oh, a silver chest. Where's that one? One to go, but I want the silver chest. Let's open this bugger up. And bunk. Oops. Broke it. And bunk. 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 And a bunk. And a bunk. And a bunk. Alright, have the next one. And a bunk. Oh, you bugger. Here we go. Bit too soon there. There's that one, that one, and eat that one, and boom, we're done. There we go, shadow purple dye. Alright then, that bugger. Ooh, replace the one I broke. No, wait, I broke three. Oh well. Okay. Let's see where the last one is planted. It's around here somewhere. No, not seeing it. Where the flip-doodle is it hiding? Oh, there it is. I didn't see that. Ooh. Hi. Okay. So, how exactly do I get rid of these? This lady knows. Hi. Huh. They're easy enough to find. For some reason, I can't destroy them. Okay. Full speed! The first time I destroyed something by ramming it, my face. Anyway. I'll send you out there alone, seems like. So I've got some things to sort out before I can match my own call mission. Okay, poisonous table. Interesting. Anyway, let's take a quick look. Dismantle that later. Oh, yeah, I got that place down, don't I? Now I just need to place this one down. Kind of matches this, doesn't it? And this. Bring those in the kitchen slash bathroom. Not the best way to have them. I need to get more rooms. I'm moving the bathroom stuff upstairs as soon as I get upstairs. Right, nothing else to do here. And we need to head to the Blood Tundra. So, let's go there. Well, here they are. Come on, finally here. I've been meaning to extend my study to Fer'al's history, to the mysterious Blood Tundra for ages. But every time I am about to make the trip, it seems something always comes up. Sometimes there's me a letter about a cool decaying monument, for instance, or get a tip about a particularly interesting sedimentary rock. You know, the kind of exciting things you just can't pass up. Now I'm finally here and there's simply too much to study. It's overwhelming. Assist? No. Actually, if you could expand boundaries of my research, which in fact, I've got a handy tool you could use. My peers always told me it was transgressive to use magic to help organize data, but if they could only see this. The Recollector. A couple of tricky chance to analyze objects and reveal pieces of their history that aren't apparent to the naked eye. Alright. I'm diving into the past. Let's travel through history! It was a fallen wayfarer and news. Recollect to see what you can learn from the submerged remains. Dark, thrilling past hidden nooks. Okay. That's a fancy little thing. So where am I going? Oh my. Wait, so that's the remains of the wayfarer? A supposed mythical being in this world? Alright. And I saw a dick spot, didn't I? I didn't. Oh well. Anyway, let's head over this way. Oh my. Well, hello. Hello there, I hear you tell you're planning to spend some time around that unfortunate skeleton. I thought I'd just keep a watchful, unblinking, bright red eye on you. That doesn't make you uncomfortable, does it? Kinda. You're kind of a weird one, aren't you? What? Not sure what exactly is going on, but not well. Let's hit the chest first. And a bump. There we go. Summarizing. This being's closest living relative is the tree. That's kind of weird. And a boing. And this one. Tracing origins, detecting history. This being was struck twice prior to neutralization. First strike was in the back. No, got hit in the back. Let's check up here before we check inside the mouth. It's just over there. Gold one. Oh my, they're going quick. Oops, it's breaking them all now. There we go. And one more. I wonder if it's possible to get over 1,000 lockpicks. Probably. I think it might max out at 999. Just breaking all my lockpicks here, so I'm never going to find out. There we go. You bugger. And now I gotta wait for the slowpoke to get all the way around. There we go. Number two. Now for number three. You bugger. And knee. And there we go. Nope. A bit too soon. Nope, a bit too late. And done. It might have been worth it. Ah! Interesting. Let's analyze this. As in case this being is dead, not gone. Well, yes. I think it's quite obvious. And more likes. And a boing, and a boing. I don't like which those guys are speaking, but oh well. Data indicates it's being lived in a climate warmer than indicated by current temperature. Oh my. So this place wasn't always frozen over. Let's open this one, and hopefully not break a bunch of lockpicks. And let's see. And boom. Done. Got a little dragon in front of us. And here, let's take a poke inside his head. Seems to be the last spot. Contextualizing. It appears a sword was used to fell this being. Time of death unknown. Back to the researcher. To tell them the research results. Now where are they? I'm that way somewhere. What on earth are those guys saying? Anywho, I guess I'll be back in a second. Anywho, we're right here. It's all quite fascinating. So much contextualized. and research and organize the reference. Okay. Interesting. That's that one done. Got another item. I'm gonna, can you change all its colors? That you can. Didn't realize I only had four colors to it. Yeah, doesn't make sense though. Anyway though, I'm gonna do a quick check on my colors, see how much I got. And now, instead of recycling every single one I have above 10, I'm gonna get them all up to 50, and then start recycling them, and actually get around to crafting. You can see you got only two of those, five of them, the bunch here that you saw a moment ago, they only got one of. So anyway, that's four of those. So, that's that all done. Who needs me? Lake Root Valley. Why, hello there. Listen up quick. This is an urgent match of life, death, and pop music. Hopefully. Are you a Flockhard? Sorry, what? Are you telling me you never heard of pop star slash performance? Artist slash style icon? Flock Ventura. Well, now's the time to become a fan because he's coming here to planet Fer'al for a Flock Ventura World Ventura. Alright. I had no idea. Okay. Dates, times, responsibilities. Missed every Flock Ventura show to now, and I sure missed this one too, but without your help. What's the problem? Funny things to be true about. Will dramatically emerge from the trapdoor at least once. Will utilize maximum glitter. Not perform anywhere near Blue Candy. That's a weird one. Of course, you'll see blue colored candy all over Fer'al. Guess nobody here is a true fan, otherwise, they'll know that the coloring they use makes Flock Ventura's throat close up. Let's destroy the dire treats to Pop Rock. Okay. Alright. So we're gonna go all the way over here to destroy some candy so this pop star or whatever shows up. What a fussy bugger. Refusing to play just because there's blue candy around. Kind of weird, really. No, well. Anyway. Oh. What the frick? Oh, there's a chest. Let's go get it. And what prize do we get in this one today? Just wait for it. Wait for it. There we go. Didn't lose a single one this time. Void spikes. I was thinking you were straight up there. And oh, there is actually a spot up here. I see another chest. Should really be going over to destroy the candy. But we got chest to open. And a bunk. And a bunk, bunk, bunk. One more. Done. And now we got to open the second one. Nyeh. You bugger! Oof. Almost a bit too soon there. Bunk. 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 And a bunk. There we go. Done. Alright. Let's get over to where I need to be. Actually, I'll use a simple trick. There's no one really over there. I was going to teleport, but no one's there. Oh well, I guess we just have to run over. Oh, there's another lockpick here. Makes you wonder how many lockpicks that guy was carrying. He dropped them. Oh, did I even show that on camera? I don't think I did. Oh well. Just held it up here. What do we have? The lockpick. A chest that I don't need to use lockpick on. And mine. Huh. Two to go. Oh, we can't jump off. That's lame. That kind of sucks. Oh well. Now where is it? All the way over there? Bloody hell, may as well just teleport this guy. Quite a long way to run. Anyway. Let's get this. And poof. Well, one more. And that is really. Yeah, I guess it's not too far away. May as well just swim there. Maybe that guy's mission later. We're over here. Boing. I'll be at it in a few seconds. Hopefully. That be you. And that one. Vein cluster. Kinda gross. Now let's see. Oh, there it is. I just gotta go back and tell the bugger. He's all the way over there. Right. I guess I'll be back in a second. And we're back. I'm gonna tell her. Left, remember when I said I wasn't great with dates or times or appointments? I definitely did have a tour scheduled and it was written down. On the calendar, I just remembered it's actually a vintage calendar that I got at a thrift store. I was wondering why all the days and weeks were off. Let's catch the next one. Interesting. Bleeding rose? Crystallized skull? The flip? Okay, got one of those for leveling up, and I got one of them from that bugger. I have no idea which one's which. Hey, that's interesting. Cool. I'm actually gonna put that down. Oh, it actually makes a mess everywhere. Weird. But you can change the colour of the red. Make it orange. Lavender. That thing. Pink. White. Slate. Whatever color you want. Same with the roses. And the leaves. And the extra bits. I need to quickly head back to my sanctuary. Okay. Now, how the frick do I get items on a table? So I'm figuring that out. Maybe if I click on it, and then click on the item? No. I was gonna say, that's a big skull. I don't think that one can go on anything. I do need to figure out how you do that. Kind of annoying that I don't know how to do it yet. Where'd that bleeding rose thingy go? Oh, there it is. That'd just be weird. Oh, we could rename it. You actually rename the rooms. You could do that. So, bleeding rose, get on the freaking table. Right click will only make it spin. You go straight to the shop. Leave those two there for now until I figure it out. I am auto-running. Oh, hello! I guess I found the basement! Well, that was interesting. Kinda weird. But I guess I found the basement. So anyway, I'm gonna end this one here. And I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.